وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله الذي خلق المكلفين ليعبدوه وأدر عليهم الأرزاق ليشكروه ووضح لهم الأدلة والبراهين ليعرفوه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الذي يتعين على العباد أن يوحدوه وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله الذي فاق الرسل من جميع الوجوه اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه جميع الذين اتبعوه أما بعد إخواني في الله إني أحبكم في الله I love you all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ashraful ulum. Knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is the greatest form of knowledge, wa afdalul fuhum, and is the greatest comprehension. Wa huwa ajalluha ala al-itlaq, and there is nothing better and greater than knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And this is by unanimous agreement of the Muslims. It is a great knowledge. It's ilmul mubarak, a blessed knowledge. Kathirul awa'id, ghazirul fawa'id, mutanawwi'ul thimar wal athar. Many benefits. Many good things are reaped from knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and learning about Him, يورث تعظيم علام الغيوب في القلوب. It will increase in your heart fearing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in private. The fear of Allah will grow in your heart. فتثمر شجرة الإيمان استلاما وإسلاما إيقانا وإحسانا. It will increase in your heart submission to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, surrendering to His commandments subhanahu wa ta'ala. Busying yourself, my beloved brothers and sisters, in learning about Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and acting upon what He commanded you and staying away from what He told you to stay away from, it is what? It's a'la al-matalib. It is the greatest thing a person can seek and look for. And once wallahi you become a person who has become that, then you are in a garden. In this dunya, you are in Jannah. In this dunya, before you even make it to the Jannah of the hereafter. As Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, إِنَّ فِي الدُّنْيَا جَنَّةِ مَنْ لَمْ يَدْخُلْهَا لَمْ يَدْخُلْ جَنَّةَ الْآخِرَةِ. Learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it calls you and it pushes you towards loving Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowing Allah will bring about fear in your heart towards Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Learning about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will bring hope in your heart. Learning about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will bring sincerity. And acting upon everything which He told you to do subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهَذَا عَيْنُ سَعَادَةِ الْعَبْدِ. And that is what happiness is. There is no way, my beloved brothers and sisters, in knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala without studying His names and attributes. There is no way to know Allah tabarak wa ta'ala without contemplating on the universal signs that are around you. There is no way in knowing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala without pondering over the Qur'an. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ عُبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ, O people, اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ, worship your Lord, الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ, the one who created you, وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, and those who came before you, He created them, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you may come with taqwa. الإمام ابن رجب رحمه الله said, فلا صلاح للقلوب حتى يستقر فيها معرفة الله وعظمته ومحبته وخشيته ومهابته ورجاؤه والتوكل عليه، ويمتلئ من ذلك. وهذا هو حقيقة التوحيد، وهو معنى قول لا إله إلا الله. فلا صلاح للقلوب حتى يكون إلهها الذي تألهه وتعرفه وتحبه وتخشاه هو إله واحد لا شريك له، ولو كان في السماوات والأرض إله يؤله سوى الله لفسدت بذلك السماوات والأرض، كما قال تعالى: لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا. انتهى كلامه. ابن رجب الحنبلي, he said, there is no way to bring about صلاح القلب, perfecting your heart, حتى يستقر فيها معرفة الله, until knowing Allah تبارك وتعالى settles in your heart, وعظمته and glorifying Allah settles in your heart, ومحبته and loving Allah settles in your heart, وخشيته and fearing Allah تبارك وتعالى settles in your heart, ومهابته and honoring Allah تبارك وتعالى settles in your heart, ورجاؤه and the hope and having hope for Allah settles in your heart, والتوكل عليه and relying on Allah تبارك وتعالى settles in your heart, ويمتلئ من ذلك وهذا هو حقيقة التوحيد, and that is the reality of توحيد, that all of that is filled in your heart, وهو معنى قول لا إله إلا الله, and he said that is what the meaning of لا إله إلا الله is. فلا صلاح للقلوب, there is nothing that can perfect a person's heart and make their heart good حتى يكون إلهها, until your Lord, your إله, the one you worship alone is him سبحانه وتعالى, الذي تألهه وتعرفه وتحبه وتخشاه هو إله واحد, it's only one إله لا شريك له, he has no partners, ولو كان في السماوات والأرض إله يؤله, and if there was an إله that deserves to be worshipped on this earth and in the samawat other than Allah, لَفَسَدَتْ بِذَٰلِكَ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضِ, the samawat and the earth will all become corrupt, كما قال تعالى, Allah, as Allah said in the ayah, لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا آلِهَةٌ إِلَّا اللَّهُ لَفَسَدَتْهَا, if there was an ilah other than Allah that deserved to be worshipped, other than any ilah that deserved to be worshipped other than Allah in this samawat or the earth, لَفَسَدَتَا, the earth and the samawat would have been corrupted. قال الله عز وجل, Allah also says in the Qur'an, خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَأَنزَلَ لَكُم مِّنَ الْأَنْعَامِ ثَمَانِيَةَ أَزْوَاجٍ يَخْلُقُكُمْ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ خَلْقًا مِّن بَعْدِ خَلْقٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ ثَلَاثٍ ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ فَأَنَّى تُصْرَفُونَ. Allah says, خَلَقَكُمْ, we created you, مِن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ, from one nafs. This one nafs Allah created us from is Adam. And Allah created us from one nafs. We all came from Adam. ثُمَّ جَعَلَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا, and then Allah made us into pairs, men and women. وَأَنزَلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَنْعَامِ ثَمَانِيَةَ أَزْوَاجٍ, and all these cattles, Allah made them into 8 pairs. يَخْلُقُكُمْ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ خَلْقًا, Allah creates in the womb of the mother what? A creation. خَلْقًا مِّن بَعْدِ خَلْقٍ, one creation after the other. فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ ثَلَاثٍ, in 3 darknesses. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ, that is your Lord. لَهُ الْمُلْكِ, he's the one who has the kingdom. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوْ, there's none worthy of worship except him. Ponder here. فَأَنَّا تُصْرَفُونَ. Who is the one? مَنِ الَّذِي أَوْجَدَنَا مِنَ الْعَدَمِ Who is the one who brought us into existence when we never existed? وَغَمَّرَنَا بِسَوَابِغَ النِّعَمِ And he placed upon us and poured upon us blessings one after the other. مَنِ الَّذِي صَرَفَ عَنَّا الْمَكَارِهَ وَالْمَضَارَّ وَالنِّقَمِ Who is the one who removed from us harm? Who is the one who removed from us problems? مَنِ الَّذِي أَعْطَانَا الْعُقُولَ وَالْأَسْمَاعَ وَالْأَبْصَارِ Who is the one who gave us intellects? Who is the one who gave us hearing and seeing? Who is the one who done that? مَنِ الَّذِي سَخَّرَ لَنَا اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ Who is the one who made for us the day and the night? مَنِ الَّذِي فَلَقَ الْحَبَّ عَنِ الزُّرُوعِ وَعَنِ الْأَشْجَارِ وَعَنِ النَّوَى Who is the one who brought the seed come from the earth and then from their trees and plants and vegetations come from it? مَنِ الَّذِي أَحْيَى الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا Who is the one who gave life to this earth after it died? You see a land, it's barren. And then it's planted and greenery and grass and everything. بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا بِمَا أَنْزَلَ عَلَيْهَا مِنْ غَيْثِ السَّمَاءِ And he did all with the rain that he has sent down from the sky. مَنِ الَّذِي يُصَوِّرُنَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ Who is the one who gave us this image and the way that we look and gave us this physique and this form in the womb of our mothers? Who is the one who does that? وَمَا بِكُم مِّن نِعْمَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ There's no blessing that you have, my beloved brothers and sisters, except that it's from Allah تبارك وتعالى. ثُمَّ إِذَا مَسَّكُمُ الضُّرُّ فَإِلَيْهِ تَجَأَرُونَ And there's no harm that afflicts us, brothers and sisters, that if we call unto Allah تبارك وتعالى, He removes it from us. It's Him we call unto. It is Him we run to, and He removes it from us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنِ الَّذِي أَمْسَكَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ عَنِ الزَّوَالِ Who is the one who stopped the heavens and the earth from perishing? مَنِ الَّذِي أَحْكَمَ خَلْقَهُمَا Who is the one who perfected the creation of what? The samawat and the earth. وَأَحْسَنَ نِظَامَهَا And he took care of the course of this earth, the rotation, and he took care of the stars and the way they function, and he took care of this earth and the way it functions, and he took care of the sky and the way it functions. فَلَا يُرَى فِيهَا خَلَلٌ وَلَا إِخْلَالٌ If you look at the sama, there's no deficient, there's no mistakes, there's no errors, there's no... Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ تَعَالَى Allah says in the Qur'an, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُمْسِكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ أَن تَزُولَا Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala is the one who holds the samawat and the ard from perishing. وَلَئِن زَالَتَا إِنْ أَمْسَكَهُمَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِهِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا And if they were to really perish, do you think life would exist after that? No. As soon as that happens, the earth is coming to an end. That's it. This life that we have will all come to an end. مَنِ الَّذِي فَجَّرَ الْأَرْضَ Who is the one who from this earth, he brings out of it, gushes from it, بِالْأَنْهَارِ وَالْعُيُونِ Rivers and springs and يعني a well, وَأَخْرَجَ الثِّمَارَ And then from that earth, يعني brings out from it, يعني seeds. From there comes plants, fruits, vegetations. وَأَخْرَجَ الثِّمَارَ اللَّذِيذَةِ وَالْفَوَاكِهَ الشَّهِيَّةِ He brings all of that. You mango, and you take this fruit, and this fruit, and this fruit. مَنِ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ فَعَدَّلَهَا وَأَحْسَنَهَا Who is the one who created the creation that we see today? All of them, in different forms and ways that they are. Who is the one who does that? مَنِ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاءَ وَبَنَاهَا Who is the one who created the samawat and he constructed it the way he constructed it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who did it. قال تعالى Allah says, رَفَعَ سَمْكَهَا فَسَوَّاهَا وَأَغْطَشَ لَيْلَهَا وَأَخْرَجَ ضُحَاهَا وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاءَهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم And he also says, يولج الليل في النهار ويولج النهار في الليل وسخر الشمس والقمر كل يجري لأجل مسمى ذلكم الله ربكم له الملك والذين تدعون من دونه ما يملكون من قطمير. Allah is the one who does that. He created the samawat, he created the heavens, he created the layl, the night, the daytime. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's the one who brings out the sun and the moon and the stars. كل يجري لأجل مسمى. All of those, the day and the night, are all happening on an appointed time. Allah sets the time when the night's going to come in, the day's going to leave, and this and that. Allah is the one who structures all of that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then look what Allah says, ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ, that is Allah, رَبُّكُمْ, your Lord, لَهُ الْمُلْكُ, he's the king of all kings, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ, and the ones that you are calling on to, وَالَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ, the ones that you are calling on to besides Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, مَا يَمْلِكُونَ مِن قِطْمِر, even a mustard seed, they don't have power and strength over it. So why are you worshipping them? Why are you calling on to them? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is the one who does that. Allah is fa'alu lima yurid. He does as he wishes, as Ibn al-Qayyim says. فَوْقَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, he's above and beyond, higher and greater than everything. وَمَعَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, and he's with everything, with his knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَادِرٌ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, and he has ability over everything. وَمُقِيمٌ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ, and he's the one who establishes everything and makes everything happen. آمِرُ النَّهِ مُتَكَلِّمٌ بِكَلِمَاتِهِ الدِّينِيَّةِ وَالْكَوْنِيَّةِ أَكْبَرُ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَأَجْمَلُ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ وَأَقْدَرُ الْقَادِرِينَ وَأَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. He speaks, subhanahu wa ta'ala, مُتَكَلِّمٌ بِكَلِمَاتِهِ, he speaks his words, الدِّينِيَّةِ, the religious commandments that he passes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He spoke it, the Qur'an that we have are the words of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he put in motion everything around us. أكبر من كل شيء, he's greater than everything. وأجمل من كل شيء, is beautiful than everything. أرحم الراحمين, the most merciful, سبحانه وتعالى. وأقدر القادرين, and he's the one who has the most ability. No one has more ability than Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وأحكم الحاكمين, and he's the judge of all judges, سبحانه وتعالى. The most merciful, the most kind. قال تعالى, Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَالِقُ الْحَبِّ وَالنَّوَى يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَمُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ فَأَنَّا تُؤْفَكُونَ. Allah is the one who brings, subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at it. You're looking at earth, and from there, يعني, look at it, brothers and sisters. The seed comes out of the earth like that. You're looking at it. How is the seed going to come out of this earth? Allah does it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah brings, يخرج الحي من الميت, he brings one that's dead from one that is alive. ومخرج الميت من الحي, he brings one that is alive from one that is dead, and one that is dead from one that is alive. ذلكم الله, all of that is Allah تبارك وتعالى. فأنت فكون. He subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives his slave even before the slave asks for it. He gives the slave فوق ما يؤمله, Allah gives the slave more than what he wanted. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala yashkuru ala al-qaleel min al-amali wa yunammih. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he does shukr of the little action that the slave does, and actually nurtures it for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yaghfiru al-kathira min al-zalali wa yamhuh. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala forgives a person for many of the sins and the shortcomings that he comes with, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he even eradicates it and he eliminates it and deletes it and cancels it for the person. يَسْأَلُهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ كُلَّ يَوْمٍ هُوَ فِي شَأْنِ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala لَا يَشْغُلُهُ سَمْعٌ عَنْ سَمْعٍ. One person's voice and their crying and supplication to Allah does not preoccupy him from the other. He hears all of them simultaneously, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He hears everybody who asks. وَلَا يَتَبَرَّمُ بِإِلْحَاحِ الْمُلَحِّينَ بَلْ يُحِبُّ الْمُلَحِّينَ فِي الدُّعَى. He loves those who are persistent in their dua, who beg him and keep begging him and keep begging him. وَيُحِبُّ أَنْ يُسْأَلْ. He loves to be asked. وَيَغْضَبُ إِذَا لَمْ يُسْأَلْ. He gets angry if he's not asked. فَيَسْتَحِي مِنْ عَبْدِهِ. He's shy from his creation. حَيْثُ لَا يَسْتَحِي الْعَبْدُ مِنْهُ. When the slave is not even shy of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَسْتُرُ حَيْثُ لَا يَسْتُرُ نَفْسَهُ. Allah conceals for the person when the person is not concealing it for his own self. He's coming out and he's talking about his sins and Allah is concealing it for him. وَيَرْحَمُهُ. Allah shows mercy to this creation. حَيْثُ لَا يَرْحَمُ نَفْسَهُ. When the person is not showing يعني, mercy to himself. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that's who he is. And that's how he is to his creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what I wanted to speak about today. The importance of knowing who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is, my beloved brothers and sisters. By knowing him, our life will change. By knowing him, we will come with what he told us to come with. And by knowing him, we will stay from away from that which he told us to stay away from. I'm going to stop there for now. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, and shaytan and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.